Now, Host A's default gateway has the actual traffic meant for the destination. Routers maintain tables called, get this, routing tables, that contain destination networks and directions for the router who to send the traffic to next. If the router's routing table doesn't have knowledge of the destination network, it can have a default route, which means a specific router interface on a different router to send traffic to. That other router interface will have a better idea of how to get to the destination. Without knowledge of the destination network or a default route, a router will drop a packet and send an error message back to the source through a protocol known as ICMP, Internet Control Message Protocol. In this story, Host A's default gateway looks in its routing table and sees that the next router interface the packet should go to is the left interface of R2. If the routers are connected by the Ethernet infrastructure, the same ARP process takes place. If the interconnection between routers doesn't use Ethernet, a different frame type is used. For example, wireless NICs use 802.11 frames instead of Ethernet frames. The same IP packet just has a different encapsulating frame. Point-to-point, directly connected serial interfaces using protocols like PPP or HDLC don't even need to deal with MAC addresses in their frames that encapsulate IP packets, since their connection is just like a tunnel. There's only one way in and only one way out. For this story, we'll just say all interfaces are Ethernet. So the right side of R1 will send an ARP request for the MAC address of the left interface of R2. There may be switches and PCs between these two router interfaces, but with or without, the story and communication between routers in this case is exactly the same. R1 sends an ARP request, a broadcast heard and read by every device on the network saying, if your IP address is 10.10.299, I need your MAC address. The left interface of R2 sends a unicast ARP reply back to R1 with its MAC address. R1 re-encapsulates the original packet sent from A to X with a new frame. The new source MAC address represents the right interface of R1, and the new destination MAC address represents the left interface of R2. R2 accepts the frame on its left interface, sees that the MAC address is its MAC address. Then R2 inspects the destination IP address, and it isn't its IP address. R2's right interface then ARPs, looking for the MAC address of R3's left interface. After the ARP reply comes back, the new source MAC of the frame is the right interface of R2. And the new destination MAC is the left interface of R3. Then R3's right interface finishes it off by actually ARPing for the destination, since the right interface of R3 is actually on the destination's network. The final frame has a source MAC address of the right interface of R3 and a destination MAC address of the actual destination, host X. The destination gets the frame, sees its MAC address, opens it up, and for the first time in the story, a device says, yes, that's my IP address too. The IP header is now stripped off and the higher layer data is sent up the networking stack on the destination for processing.